साहिल सेन तामिटकर टू प्रेजेंट यू ऑन टॉपिक सेफ्टी इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग. द कंटेंट्स आर फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन, इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ सेफ्टी, कॉजेस ऑफ एक्सीडेंट्स, कंक्लूजन्स एंड देन रेफरेंसेस. इंट्रोडक्शन. द सिविल इंजीनियरिंग इंडस्ट्री इज वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट इंडस्ट्री इन द मॉडर्न टाइम्स. इट इज ऑल्सो एन इंडस्ट्री वेयर एक्सटेंसिव यूज ऑफ लेबर इज रिक्वायर्ड एंड वेयर सच लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ ह्यूमन लेबर इज इन्वॉल्व. A matter of safety arises. In India, safety in construction is not a serious issue and is neglected quite often. Importance of safety. Safety on construction sites protects the public. Construction sites are usually located in busy areas where the general public is coming and going. Inadequate safety protocols can allow objects to fall on innocent bystanders, putting people not even connected to the project at high risk. Safety reduces work-related accidents. Not only does construction site safety decreases the risk of injuries to the public, but it also reduces the risk of work-related injuries and accidents. Falls. Being struck by an object, electrocution, or being caught in between equipment are the four most common causes of accidental deaths and other injuries. Having a culture of safety reduces the risk of this type of accidents. Third, decrease time and money lost after an accident. When an accident occurs that causes an injury or death, work stops. The severe nature of this accident requires investigation, and work cannot continue while the research is underway. Construction site accidents also drive up the overall cost of your project. Often equipment or supplies are damaged and your overhead will increase. Fourth, for injured workers compensation claims can increase total operating costs. Causes of accidents. Unsafe working conditions, falling from heights, falling debris or objects, electrocutions and power tool accidents, excessive noise, vibrating tool hazards, scaffolding accidents, stepladder misuse, construction vehicle accidents. First, unsafe working conditions. An unsafe working condition is a condition in which the physical layout of the workplace or work location, the status of tool equipment and materials are in violation of the contemporary safety standards. Here in this images you can see that the first one, the man is standing on the three cans. Then in the second image we can see that the man is standing on the ladder, and on the ladder there is a bucket of something. Then falling from heights. Falling accidents typically occur when a worker steps to or backwards an open sided floor or slab and focuses on the work. Second, slips, trips and low falls are the most common forms and usually cause minor injury. Example, musculoskeletal disorder or puncture wounds, etc. By contrast, fatal accidents can be caused by falls from height, and in most cases workers suffer from head or shoulder wounds. Lack of opening protections, inadequate edge protections may lead to potential falling hazards. Then, falling debris or objects. A construction site has heavy machineries, tools and materials. A worker can easily stuck in between immovable objects, machineries and fallen debris. Next, electrocutions and power tool accidents. Electrocution can be caused by body contact with power cables, cable strikes on underground utilities, or defective or ground fault protection. Power tool accidents such as nail gun injuries are usually caused by inappropriate use or inadequate eye protection. Furthermore, improper guards in the place on power tool management may lead to more severe injuries. Excessive noise, vibrating tool hazards. Noise and vibrating tools are also a cause for concern whilst working in the construction industry, as excessive noise from poor tools can cause hearing loss or problems such as tinnitus. ringing in the ears. The vibration from power tools can cause nerve and tendon damage to the hands, arms, and wrist, which is experienced can be extremely debilitating with reduction and sometimes total loss of grip strength. Next, scaffolding accidents. Scaffolding accidents cause large number of deaths and injuries every year. Most accidents are caused by scaffold equipment failure, inadequate scaffolding safety training, lack of personal fall protective systems, or improper scaffolding equipment operation. In addition, materials and tools falling may also cause injuries. Step ladder misuse. The majority of falls in construction accidents are due to step ladder misuse or failures. Ladder injuries include loss of balance, improperly ladder setting up, loss of balance, and exceeding the ladder weight capacity, etc. Construction vehicle accidents. Large construction equipment, example cranes, forklifts, dump trucks, or road graders and concrete mixer, etc., may become potential danger on a construction site. Due to their weight and size, workers and drivers can be seriously injured or killed in an accident. In some cases, drivers may not have competent driving skills or their visibility may be limited due to the site constraints. Conclusion. Safety is very important in civil engineering industry, but the safety scenario in the construction industry, especially in India, is very poor, which results in lots of casualties, which hampers the normal working of the project. These are the references from where I got the informations. Thank you.